Kevin Zuden. Welcome back to Jintai Academy and another video in our ongoing series of educational support and programming for beauty and barber professionals. Today at Jintai Academy, we want to talk about memberships. Everybody wants to be part of the club. You know, I think it was maybe Yogi Berra or maybe one of these other comedy type guys who said, I don't want to be a member of any club that would let me in. Well, memberships can be powerful tools for barbershops and hair salons to build and grow business and to support their best customers and to encourage customer loyalty. Let's take a look at a couple of tips related to membership programming for barbershops and hair salons. Number one, only offer a limited number of memberships. Start with a very small number. If you're an independent businessman with a small shop, I love the idea. 25 memberships. Only sell 25 memberships. They're a form of prepaid sales. You want to be able to account for the money really well, but a little bit of exclusivity. Everybody wants to be a member of a club that they can't join. If there aren't a lot of spots, all of a sudden, wait a minute, I want in on this. Limit the number of memberships that you offer. It can be expanded later, but initially, keep the number small and extend it as a private offer to a limited number of your very best customers. Scarcity makes people want it. It creates interest. So, next up on the list, membership is not a discount. And I cannot stress this enough. If you're going to offer a price for unlimited haircuts for a month, you know, 6 month period, 1 year period, whatever, we'll talk about that in a minute. But over the course of a month, a customer is paying a flat fee for unlimited haircuts. Do the math. If your customers typically come in every 2 weeks, at least the price of membership should be double the price of a haircut. Now, a membership is not a discount, and I'll get to why in just a minute. If your customer base comes in every week, 4 times the price of a haircut. If your customer base comes in once a month, your membership should at least be 1.5 times the cost of a haircut because you're gambling. You're gambling that they're not going to come in as often, and your customers are gambling that they're going to come in more often so that they come out ahead on the money. It's not a discount. Why would you want a discount to what are already your best customers and your greatest source of revenue? Don't shoot yourself in the foot. Here's the deal. The secret to memberships is membership value comes in the form of the added benefits of membership. So it's not a discount on the haircuts, but you've got to ask yourself, and you've got to ask your customers. One of the best ways to build a membership program is to do a customer survey and ask your customers, hey, we're going to do a membership program. What benefits would be valuable to you? Do you want early or late hours? Do you want premium appointment booking? Do you want an ongoing product discount? Do you want a complimentary conditioning treatment with your haircut service? There's so many ways that you can build value into a membership package that has nothing to do with discounting the basic haircut. I can't stress this enough. If you don't think you can run a membership program without discounting the haircut, don't run a membership program. Next on the list, memberships gotta be long. You can't do 1 month memberships. You can charge it per month, but I believe membership should be 6 months or a year. You sign up 6 months or a year. And in the beginning of the video, when we talked about limiting the number, one of the things I like about a limited number of memberships is perhaps you make memberships available 5 at a time, once a month. January, you open up 5. February, you open up 5. And you sell those memberships, those 5, and then you stop. I'm sorry, I have no more memberships available at this time. I'm limiting it. Limited it absolutely to no more than about 10% of your total customer base, big picture. But by limiting it that way, the memberships are starting sequentially throughout the year. You don't have all the revenue coming in at once and then no revenue coming in. You're balancing your cash flow, number one. Number two, 6 months to a year, when an individual who has a membership, if they choose to terminate their membership, not renew their membership, that one membership now becomes available and you can put a sign up, you can put a post out on social media that says, hey, we've got some membership openings coming out. Creating that scarcity, creating that excitement, creating a reason for somebody to jump on a membership when they learn that one's available. Nothing could be better than 5 a month times 12 months, a total of 60 memberships, and for you to have in a file drawer or in a file on your phone or in your computer, a waiting list of people who've said, hey, if a membership opens up, dude, I want in. How cool would that be? Talk about leveraging memberships to build your business in a very cool way. And that's what I got for you. That's my recap of some of what I believe are the important points related to building, creating, and offering memberships in barbershops or hair salons. I'm Ivan Zoot for Jatai Academy. Thanks for watching. Good luck with the membership program. If I can help you, reach out to me online at clipperguy.com. I love coaching barbershops and hair salons on building and executing successful membership programs. I think it's a great asset to your marketing portfolio. Thanks for watching and have a great day.